Hello friends, today we are going to see a new topic, viscosity. So guys, have you ever thought why water takes less time to reach from one point to other than oil? Why taking out jam or honey from its bottle is a tough task? Well, answer to these questions is viscosity. So the definition of viscosity in simple words, it is the property of fluid that offers resistance to its flow. Higher the viscosity of fluid, higher will be the resistance. This is just a definition, but we are going to see in detail what happens exactly at molecular level and why it is important to learn the concept of viscosity in next few slides. If we see the molecular structure of fluid flowing through a tube, we can see that fluid flows in the form of layers, and the layers of fluid which are at the center of tube has more velocity than layers of fluid or molecules which are close to the inner surface of tube. Due to this difference in velocities of fluid layers, the layers with low velocity offers resistance to the flow of layer with high velocity. And if the intermolecular resistance is very high, then overall speed of fluid flow decreases. Such fluids with high resistance to flow are called as viscous fluids. In short, if we want the fluid to move, we have to apply the force so as to overcome this resistance. If the fluid is more viscous, we have to apply more force. Whereas, if the fluid is less viscous, then resistance will be less and the force required will also be less. Term viscosity is very important term of fluid mechanics. Wherever fluid flow occurs, we have to take the viscosity into consideration. During design process of any fluid carrying or storing facility, we have to take the viscosity of fluid being handled into consideration. In design process itself, selection of pumps, pipes and other accessories mainly depends on viscosity of fluid. If we are designing a system for slurry handling, the pipes and pumps will be different than the system which is designed to carry water or oil. Now the next example is selection of lubricant. It also depends upon viscosity of fluid. While selecting the fluid for lubrication purpose, it is expected that the fluid should also always maintain a constant film of oil between two moving parts so as to avoid friction and allow smooth motion, but same time it is expected that it should not create any resistance to the motion. Here also viscosity is the important criteria which helps us in selecting correct lubricant. So friends, I hope you have understood the topic well, but still if you have any doubts, please comment below. Thank you for watching.